This program was paid for by Water of Life Church. From Water of Life Ministries in Plano, Texas, the God of Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob is speaking through his servants to the world. He that hath ears to hear, let him hear what the Spirit of the Lord is saying today. Let us join Doyle Davidson and others of Water of Life, sowing the Word of God in spirit and in truth.
Hello, I'm Doyle Davidson, servant and apostle of the Lord Jesus Christ, ministering locally to the body of Christ, Dallas, Fort Worth, Texas, sent by God, your house, to declare unto you the gospel of the Lord Jesus Christ. Amen. 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 I'm going to move forward on my own. The suspense of every song, everything, because God has got something to say to Water of Life and to the world. Are we on live? Are we on shortwave?
Yes.
Roku, Apple TV, YouTube, other devices. We are.
Yes.
Thank you. I must say, I'm a very humble man, a very meek man. A man that God brought out of the professional and business world to serve me. I was a horseman. I had some good ones. I was a veterinarian. I was very successful. Amen. And God put me in this church. Amen. About people only respected some theologian that would lie. Amen. Look at it. Once I was at a little gospel businessmen's meeting. And God, some man stood up and said, God told him that there were X number of people that would give $100 to the offering. And bam. And it went along for, I don't know, 30, 40 people. They give out and it stopped. I thought, this is not God. This is not God. This is not God. This is not God. And bam. But I just sat there. Pretty soon, others started giving $100. The Lord said to me, you know why? You know why they quit giving? I said, no. He said, because of my unbelief. Amen. Once, I had a preacher here. At Water of Life, speaking. And he said to me later, Doyle, that man sitting right out there is stopping your ministry from moving. He doesn't want your ministry to move. I said, oh? He said, I've seen men like him that would shut down a ministry. I said, you have? Yeah. Abbott. I said, thank you. Some months later, God made him give Water Life Ministries $100,000. Amen. $100,000. Amen. Then he pushed him out of the church. Amen. There's a man here. I know your name. I'm going to tell you something. You're that kind of person. And God is telling me to tell you to write a check right now for $10,000 and put it in the treasury. Amen. $10,000 in the treasury. Thank God. Now, I'll give you some time to get it done. If you don't get it done, I'm going to call your name. I'm going to put you out in front of the whole world. You see, I don't care. You stubborn, stiff-necked man think you can stop the Holy Ghost. No way. So let's listen to a couple carried by songs recorded. Did I already name them?
Yes. Two and three.
Huh?
Two and three.
That's it.
Yeah. fear and doubt come against your mind? Has your faith been sorely tried? Lift up your eyes, here cometh your help. It is Jesus, he has given you life. So rise and be
watch God make you a rich man, elevate you in a position that made you have a lot of recognition, and you like it. But you resist God with your covetousness. God is dealing with you, telling you to repent before it's too late. Amen. Amen. I watch God make you a wealthy man. Amen. Amen. Thank God. Amen. And you need to obey God with $10,000 to water of life now. Amen. 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 Thank God. Amen. God, amen. Amen. You got something?
I have something to share when you're ready.
Well, I guess I better have this lady. Came here in 1985. came out of an organization, a technique, a group of pseudo-intellectuals. Why do you call them pseudo-intellectuals? The intellectual is honest. They're honest. They speak it like it is. Pseudo's a false intellectual. Any intellectual, an honest, a good one, can teach the Bible, spent on a fifth grade. Fifth grade level, and back. This lady came here, 1985. She didn't know me, never heard of me. God brought her mother here, and her, and other family members. And back. Okay. Amen. I recall in 1974, I was in great trouble. A man with a lot of success, didn't know what failure was. Amen. And God had led me into the wilderness. And I was in great trouble. Financial trouble. Amen. Financial. Never been a financial problem in my life. Amen. But God, who's greater than man, can take you into your own craftiness and make a fool out of you. That's what he did with me. Amen. That's what he did with you too. Amen. Thank God. Amen. Thank God. Amen. Thank God. Amen. I'm going to tell you, sir, you're in trouble with God. Trouble with God. You don't want God on your case. You'll find out what he'll do to you. He'll bring you low. Real low. Amen. Amen. Thank you. Amen. I will tell you, you're in danger of great trouble for you and your family. Amen. Amen. Thank you. Amen. Your friends can't save you. Amen. 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 Thank you. Amen. Amen. We have a woman that's, are you up here? I appreciate how God has led her, humbled her, set her free, putting her into his kingdom because she would humble herself and obey. Amen. And in 1974, I was in great trouble in the wilderness. God led me to study, read King David, when he sat before the Lord. Amen. And he talked to the Lord. He was a successful person. Amen. Successful person. And he was overwhelmed with what God was doing with his life, as I am. Amen. And he prayed a prayer that somewhere in there, he said, who am I? David did to the Lord. He said, the thing that thou said to thy servant and his household, do as thou said, and establish it forever. And that's what God is doing with my house, and my friends. Those with me, there's one of them that is with me. Terre Brown, then some were mine. Amen.
When I think of how he came so far from glory, came to dwell among the lowly, such as us. On Mount Calvary, take my place. Then I ask myself this question, who am I? Who am I that the King would bleed and die for? Who am I that he would pray, not my will, thine, Lord? The answer I may never know. Why you ever loved me so? That to an old rugged cross he'd go. For who am I? When I'm reminded of his word, I'll leave thee never. If you'll be true, I'll give to you life forever. Oh, I wonder what I could have done to deserve God's only Son, to fight my battles until they're won. For who? Not my will, thine, Lord. The answer I may never know. Why he ever loved me so? That to an old rugged cross he'd go. For who am I? That to an old rugged cross he'd go.
Going well.
What's that?
It is. We've got about 32 minutes left.
Amen. As the man brought the 10,000 to the treasury, No answer? Can somebody look in the treasury and see if it's in there?
Yes, Terry's on her way.
What?
Terry is on her way to look in the treasury.
It's what?
Terry is on her way to look in the treasury.
Thank you. Amen. 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 Look at it. Amen. 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 Look at it. Amen. Amen.
No.
No there?
No.
That man is Steve Brown. Have mercy on him, Lord. Have mercy. Pray for mercy. Him and his family. Thank God. Amen. No covetous man shall enter into the kingdom of heaven. None. None cannot enter to the kingdom of heaven. Amen. I want to hear adoration and God bless us. Amen. 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 Amen.
Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah.
We got 21 minutes left.
What?
21 minutes left.
You want to talk?
Yes, I will.
What?
Yes, I will.
Go for it.
I want you to turn with me to Philippians 2. We have been talking about this Jesus. And for the last week, I've been talking about how Jesus was a God. He humbled himself and became a man. If you've ever been tempted to where you think you cannot do this, you cannot go one more step.
Amen.
There's a man that went before you. And I'm going to show you tonight how that man overcame his temptation. If you will go with me to Philippians 2. Verse 5, let this mind be in you, which was also in Christ Jesus. It says, who being in the form of God, in the form of God, thought it not robbery to be equal with God, but made himself of no reputation. That word there, if you look it up, means emptied himself of all his godly ability. Jesus emptied himself. Himself, if you look at the word himself, amen. God didn't do it to him, Jesus did it himself. Amen. And it says he emptied himself. Then NIV said he became nothing. He amen. Became nothing. And if we want to walk with Jesus, that's where we've got to go. It says he humbled himself and became obedient. It says, and took upon himself the form of a servant and was made in the likeness of men. And being found in fashion as a man, no longer a God, as a man. He could no longer be everywhere at once. He could no longer know everything at once. He could no longer create anything. He had no power, none. He gave it all up and became a man. And it says, and being found in fashion as a man, he humbled himself even more. It said, and became obedient. Not only a man, but a servant, and became obedient even to the death of the cross. Wherefore, God has highly exalted him and given him a name which is above every name. Go with me to Hebrews 5. We are going to look at Jesus in one of the most remarkable experiences I've ever read in the Bible. It's one of my favorite because I understand a whole lot more of what happened in the garden. When Jesus was in the garden, if you will look with me tonight, you will see humanity was saved in the garden. In the garden. The humanity, us, we were saved, and it began in the garden. All right, it says Hebrews 5, verse 7, who in the days of his flesh, this is talking about Jesus, when he had offered up prayers and supplications with strong crying and tears, unto him that was able to save him from death, was heard and that he feared. And though he were a son, the son of God, yet learned he obedience. Jesus himself had to learn obedience. The God that was God, that was the Word, became flesh and had to learn obedience. Do you know what? So do we. It says, who though he were a son, yet learned he obedience by the things which he suffered. Jesus suffered. And we're going to take a look at one of the hardest sufferings. It says, in being made perfect, he became the author of eternal salvation. Amen. Jesus wasn't perfect when he was in the garden. Amen. He was far from perfect. And we'll take a look at that. But first, go with me to John 12. We'll see what Jesus says about what he's getting ready to do. Amen. I've used this verse several times, one of my favorite, because it shows the humanity of Jesus. It shows his soul. Amen. It shows how much he was like us. In John 12, 27, it says, now is my soul troubled. But what shall I say? Father, save me from this hour. But for this cause came I unto this hour. Now he's going into the garden. If you'll turn with me to Mark 14. We're going to take a look at what happened to Jesus in the garden. Now you have to remember, Jesus is not a God. He has no power. The only power he had was through the Holy Ghost. He could do no miracle. He said that 5 times in John. He said, it is not me doing the works. Of my own self, I can do nothing. It is the Father that worketh through me. I can do nothing. And now he's faced with the garden. And we just read in John that he's troubled. And now we're going to find out how troubled he is. Mark 14, verse 32. And it came to a place in which is called Gethsemane. And he said to his disciples, sit you here while I shall pray. And he taketh with him Peter and James and John, and began to be sore amazed. Amen. Sore amazed. That means he was struck with terror. Jesus was struck with terror. Amen. Our Messiah is in the garden, and he has flesh like you and I. And you will find here that Jesus is in a conflict, a great conflict. And the conflict is in his own heart. It's in his own soul. Amen. Jesus had a soul like ours. And right now he's struck with terror. Why? Because he knows what's going to happen on the tree. He can read. He knew it from the very first. In fact, it says in Psalms, I was born to do this. And God supplied me a body. And now he's looking at it straight on. And his soul doesn't want to go. His soul doesn't want to go to the cross. And we'll see that. He has a soul like you and I. Now, how is he going to overcome his soul? Have you ever been in a fight, a conflict with your spirit and soul? And you know your soul is way up here and your spirit's way down there. And you got to get them reversed. You got to get your spirit over your soul so you can obey what you need to do. Amen. And this is what Jesus is doing here. We are going to see the perfect example of how to overcome our own flesh. It says, and they came into a place that's called Gethsemane. And he said to his disciples, sit you here while I pray. And he taketh with him Peter, James, and John, and began to be sore amazed and very heavy. And he saith unto them, my soul is exceeding sorrowful unto death. That word means, that means when you look at it, it's sorrow as if to cause, so sorrowful as if to cause death. Jesus' soul wanted to die in the garden. He wanted to die in the garden. Why did he want to die in the garden? So he wouldn't have to go to the cross. So he wouldn't have to experience the cross. Isaiah 52 says, for he was marred more than any man. Any man. Jesus had seen crucifixions. He's been in Jerusalem. He knew what was going to happen to him. And his soul didn't want to go. And it says, and he went forward a little place and fell on the ground and prayed, if it were possible. If it were possible. He said that the hour might pass from him. And he said, Abba, Father, all things are possible unto thee. Take away this cup from me. Take it away. I don't want to go to the cross. That is his soul speaking. And then you hear his spirit speaking. He said, nevertheless, not what I will, but what thou wilt. You know what? It wasn't a simple change of attitude. It wasn't a simple change of attitude at all. If you will go with me to Luke 24, let's take a look at this account. And you will say it wasn't a simple attitude change. He had to get his flesh in line to go to the cross. Do you realize if Jesus loses this fight in the garden, you and I would have had no hope. You and I would not have had an intercessor. You and I would not have had a sacrifice. Jesus has to get to the garden and he knows it. Luke 22, verse 39. And he came out and went as he went to the Mount of Olives, and his disciples followed him. Amen. And when he was at the place, he said to them, pray that you enter not into temptation. Amen. And he was, and you know who he was talking to? Himself. Amen. He was talking to himself besides the disciples. Pray that you not enter into this temptation. Because he's tempted to walk away. Amen. He said, and he was withdrawn from them about a stone's cast and kneeled down and prayed, saying, Father, if thou be willing, if thou be willing, he says, remove this cup from me. There's the soul speaking. And now we hear the spirit. Nevertheless, not my will, but thine be done. And look at what the wonderful thing that the Father's doing with his son. You know, it says in Isaiah 42 that the Father upheld Jesus and he will upheld us. And the Father's upholding Jesus. And you can see right here what the Father does from him. Amen. The Father doesn't let anybody touch him. The guards aren't here yet. No. They're not going to come. Right. And you will see those guards won't come until Jesus is ready. That is the mercy and the grace of God. And he will do the same thing for you. He will do the same thing for you. Look at the graciousness of God. He is waiting. He is waiting until Jesus is ready. And now if you look, he even does this. And he says, and there appeared an angel unto him from heaven, strengthening him. Do you see what the Father did? He sent him an angel to strengthen him. He sent him an angel to strengthen him. He can't change Jesus' flesh. Jesus has to get through this, but he sends an angel to strengthen him. And then look what happens. Look what happens with the fight. Look at the soul of Jesus. Look at the fight. Look at the war Jesus is having with himself. He does not want to go to the cross. He says, and being in an agony, he prayed the more earnestly. In an agony, he prayed harder. He said he prayed more earnestly. Why? He knows. He told his disciples, pray you that you enter not in temptation. Pray so you don't sin. He doesn't want to lose it here. He said, and being in an agony, he prayed more earnestly. And his sweat were as it great drops of blood falling to the ground. That is the agony Jesus is in. And he's trying to get his soul underneath his spirit. He's trying to get his spirit in control so he can go to the cross. He can't go to the cross in this condition. He can't go to the cross in this condition. He's got to go to that cross in faith. He has got to have the faith to go to the cross. He has got to have the faith to make sure everything happens on the cross that needs to happen. And he's got to get his spirit above his soul. He's got to get his soul down. He's got to put his soul away. He's got to get that soul down so he can go to the cross. And he's in an agony. He's in agony. And he prays more earnestly, and his sweat was at great drops of blood falling down to the ground. And now let's go back to Mark, and we'll catch back here what's going on with Jesus. If you have ever been in a place you don't want to be, look at what Jesus did. Amen. And that man is in us, and he can walk it again. Amen. It says, Abba, Father, all things, I'm beginning in 36. He said, Abba, Father, all things are possible unto thee. Take away this cup from me. Get it out of here. Take it away. I don't want to go. Amen. Nevertheless, not what I will, but what thou wilt. And he cometh and he findeth them sleeping, his disciples, and said unto them, said unto Peter, he knows what Peter's going to be. He knows what Peter's going to do. Jesus is in the garden trying to get a hold of his soul. Peter's asleep. Peter, Simon, sleepest thou? Couldest not thou watch 1 hour? Watch and pray, lest you enter into temptation. The spirit truly is ready. He's talking about himself here. The spirit truly is ready, but the flesh is weak. His spirit is the spirit of Jesus. It's the spirit that was there and created the worlds. But now he's in a fleshly body, and that soul doesn't want to go to the cross. Remember, he said that he was exceeding sorrowful unto death. Unto death. His soul wanted to die in the garden so it wouldn't have to go to the cross. And he goes away and he prays again, speaking the same words. And when he returned, he found them asleep again, for their eyes were heavy. And neither wist they what to answer him. 3 times Jesus went away in an agony, praying, getting his soul to go down so that he could obey the Father. It said Jesus learned obedience by the things that he suffered. Amen. And he is suffering right here. The man doesn't want to go, but he knows he has to. And he's got to get his spirit up. 3 times he goes and prays. And you know what? Listen to these next words and you will see that he won. That he got his spirit, he got his soul down, and he's got his spirit. He prayed through. He prayed through the garden. Now he's getting ready to go obey the Father on the tree. What did Philippians say? He humbled himself to obedience, even to the death of the cross. Oh. He had to humble his soul. He had to humble that soul and do what the Father wanted him to do, and he had to do it in faith. He had to do it in faith. And the third time, he prays. And now look what he says to the disciples. Sleep on now and take your rest. It is enough. It is enough. It is enough. I'm ready to go. Do you see those wonderful words? It is enough.
Oh.
It is enough. I am ready to go to the cross. And now look what happens. It didn't happen. It didn't happen until he was ready. It didn't happen until he could say, it's enough. And look what the Father does now. He said, it is enough. The hour has come. Behold, the Son of Man is betrayed into the hands of sinners. Rise up, let us go. Lo, he that betrayeth me is at hand. And the next words, and immediately, while he yet spoke, Judas, one of the 12, with him, and a great multitude with swords and staves from the chief priests and scribes and Pharisees, came to get him. God did not let Judas show up with the guards until Jesus was ready. And Jesus, in agony, prayed 3 times. And he told Peter, can you not pray 1 hour? 3 hours. 3 hours it took Jesus to pray through. And you know what? Jesus knew he was going for us. He had to get his soul humbled. His soul humbled so he could do the will of the Father. And when he got there, and when he said it's enough, then the Father sent Judas. Do you see the love of God here? Do you see the love of God for us? And do you see the love of God for Jesus? Do you know it says in John 17? I want us to go there. You think, yeah, but that was Jesus. That's how much the Father loved Jesus. I want to show you a verse. In John 17, it says, let's go to 23. This is Jesus speaking to the Father, a prayer. He said, I in them and thou in me, that they may be perfect in one, that the world may know that thou hast sent me and has loved them as thou hast loved me. Do you know the Father loves you as much as he does his Son? Do you know it is written right here? He said, and has loved them as thou hast loved me. In the last verse, and I have declared unto them thy name and will declare it, that the love wherewith thou hast loved me may be in them. The Father loves you just as much as he loves his Son. And he will do the same thing for us. And we have the Spirit of Jesus in us. So if you are ever tempted not to obey God, look at Jesus in the garden. And that Spirit is in you. Amen.
Amen.
We have 3 minutes left.
3 minutes? Thank God. One of the great stories you'll ever hear. Ministered by a woman. It's the best I've ever heard. Preaching the milk of the Word. I've been in a few times of great distress. Never anything compared to where Jesus has been. Never. I thought more than once I would die. But the Lord told me in 09 I wouldn't die. I resisted the death. The death of the devil, the death of man, wicked spirits. I'm grateful for the love and the faith that the Lord won for me, made for me on the cross. It was his love that he went to the cross. Oh, it's the love of God. It was the love. It was his faith, but his love. The love of God. In the heart of Jesus, he said, for my love, you've become my adversary.
Too
Isaiah 2?
Yes.
Every man, for my good, you've given me evil. Every man. Thank God. Bless God. I thank God for leading me in the paths he's led me to be persecuted by his people. Yeah. I thank God. I thank God that I was found worthy to be a servant of God. You can find that in Matthew 10. Go to a house where they're worthy. Where they're worthy. Thank God. Thank God I've been found worthy to serve Jesus. Didn't deserve it. God just found me worthy. Serve Jesus.
30 seconds.
Amen. My friends, there's only one name under heaven whereby one must be saved. Jesus Christ of Nazareth. The Father has given you the faith and the love, faith and the grace to be saved. Speak Jesus after me and be saved. Jesus.
We invite you to visit Water of Life Church at 1621 18th Street in Plano, Texas. Or for further information, call area code 972-578-8082. That's 972-578-8082. Or write Doyle Davidson, Post Office Box 861327, Plano, Texas 75086. That's Doyle Davidson, Post Office Box 861327, Plano, Texas 75086. This program was paid for by Water of Life Church.